Hello, welcome to Spring Thunder Forge Alliance Forever. Excuse me, today we're on ladder again. And no tourney this time, and got two players in around 2k rating. Torin Torumbar in the blue, Seraphim is on the top. And the bottom left is Mephi in the red playing Cybrim. So, Forbidden Pass, casted this before, it's a pretty tough map, and yeah, see second air, so players will like grab some tree reclaim. These are all tree groups here, there's also tree groups here, and here, and here, and here, and here. All this, pretty much all the trees are tree groups, and players are gonna use this to get T2 or to get air as their second factory. Torin, you can see, only has 4 P-gens queued up, so usually you see like 4 or 5 P-gens. You don't really see so much second land on this map because it's a very long route to actually get your land units somewhere useful, somewhere into an attacking position, so you usually just see second air. Also, because losing air in this map is very painful, so the earlier you start your air production, the more air you're gonna have. So second air is pretty much standard on this map. Also have a pretty early hydro to get, should allow you to do more air. So Torin is already walking even before he finishes his air factory. You usually walk your ACU to this position, you can walk over this ridge here. So Mephi, you can see, whoa, Mephi is not using the tree reclaim. Actually, he's using some. Look at the reclaim, he actually has 8 P-gens, and he has reclaimed a bit less than Torin. Torin, let's see, he is actually stalling now. He was a bit too greedy, didn't actually do enough reclaiming, but he should be okay now. Yeah, he's gotta use this NG to get some reclaim. And we have a bomber out. So bombers have no radar now, so you really have to use those scouts to let you find your targets. And you can see, well, you should use air scouts anyway. I mean, one air scout here scouts the entire landmass here pretty much on its own, so it's pretty fucking epic. A lot of units here. This is all NGs. Oh, we've got a Mantis protecting them, Mantis scout. And 3 engineers. This should be the target, and then if he's lucky he can get another one, but there's 2 inties out for Mephi, and now we see actually why he's gone for so many P-gens. I mean, he could have got more tree reclaim here for sure, but got a lot of P-gens so he could get 2 interceptors out and then rush a transport. And this is a pretty good move very early. Bit unusual, you don't usually see a transport this quickly. And the transport may have been spotted there by this bomber. Oh, it's aiming at radar. It's not the best thing to aim for, but it's fine. So the transport is out. He's not actually dropping here. I definitely think he should drop an engineer here. And then move on to this position. But there's actually tanks already on the way to probably deny him that position. And the transport has actually stopped. That's not sure why. Yeah, I mean, if you're gonna rush something that fast, you don't want to stop halfway there. Looks like he can actually win air as well. This is pretty sloppy from Torin to leave his air out. in basically no man's land. And if you see someone do that, definitely take advantage and win that air control. And that's what Miffy did. You can see he has 2 inties left over, pretty much full health, and he killed two, only lost one. So that's gonna put him in a good position in air. Miffy is gonna be. Yeah, you see he kept his common base to use that build power to make sure he got the transport out, so he sent an engineer in his place to this position. And it's actually basically fine. I mean, you can't protect it as a Cybran, because you're just not going to get land units there pretty much. But players are just not ready for this. They just expect an ACU there. Even if they see the blip on the radar, they'll think it's an ACU because it's kind of the same speed and almost, and you just don't expect it. So if you are playing this map, you can take advantage of this, but you also need to watch out for it yourself and scout and make sure that there's actually an ACU there. Otherwise, just take advantage of that, because it's a risky play to just send one engineer here, and if it's punished, you're going to be in a bit of trouble. So Mephi actually saw the units here and decided to drop here instead, where there are no units. Pretty nice. And he actually had a couple of Mantis here. I think he picked those up along the way because he didn't have those on there originally, and that's pretty nice. Early tank drops, Mantis drops are really good because there's not many units around and they're quite slow to get to position. So he wanted to drop here. He had to kind of abort that mission because Torin's air arrived, but he should find this engineer kill, and then he can eventually maybe kill a couple of mexes. It will take some time. Mephi or Torin trying to hide behind this factory, and he's doing a pretty good job at that. So Mephi needs to pay attention and make sure he gets that kill. In air, we can see Torin's added another air factory because, well, he's behind. No, Mephi. I think it's Torin stalling. Yeah, this factory should be done already, but he has so little power, in fact. That is, yeah, 380 power, and there goes the engineer. I think if he wasn't stalling, that factory would be finished. Yeah, Torin should mix in some mobile anti-airs right about now. He has a lot of tanks, so he needs to make use of them. Mephi does have the air control, but I don't think he has as many units at all. We can see about 20 units, and yeah, there's quite a few more for Torrent. Looking in the base, we don't see any teched mexes. I don't see any T2 land or air. In Torrent's base, similar story, no eco, no tech at the minute. Here's an air factory again. Yeah, he could reclaim some of these trees. They're still good to reclaim. Here's a big patch of tree groups. So if you are in a bit of trouble for power, just try and use this. I usually have an NG try to reclaim as much as possible after I build the first factory in this position, for example. Give you a bit of a boost. Now, the way to use the commander in this map is usually walk to here and then make your way across and try and secure this position. And when you secure this, then you basically stop anything from getting back here, barring raids. So usually by the time you get to here, your opponent will have PD, so you should always bring arty with your commander to this position. You're also going to need tanks, because there are going to be tanks here, because your opponent wants to raid this way and also defend this position. And we do actually see Torin move in. This is really nice. He can take down the factory. He can take down all the mexes. He has more reinforcements coming in, and Mephi is kind of out of position. He doesn't have units with him to actually take this, although there is no PD. There's enough units that it's a bit risky for him to try and take this. Torin actually can't take this either. Just not enough units over here. And no Arty. He should be careful. I would stick a bit closer to water if I was him. Actually, Mephi is similar to Torin down here. Wipes out this position. And I don't see units moving across from the base. I think he needs to redirect some of these rally points. There's a T2 mech. And T2 mech started for Mephi as well. And Torin is going to take some damage here. I don't think he has... He does actually have overcharge. So that's another thing. If you don't want to... If you don't have RD with you, then get some OC. Build that energy storage. And then you can take out PD pretty easily. And if you get the right angle on a PD, your commander will shoot the PD and not the walls. Nice move from Mephi, dropping this position. I was just thinking that Torin should do this here. When you have something secured with some T1 land units, drop some engineers there, secure better with a PD, get the reclaim, and then maybe build a factory if you want, but mostly you want to get the reclaim and a PD just to slow your opponent down even more, because you should expect to, Mephi should expect to lose this position at some stage. So he just wants to really delay Torin getting it back as much as possible. And I mean, if you get to keep it, then, well, that's fucking great for you. Mephi, total air dominance, but I'm not really seeing much aggressive air units. Here is a bomber. You can see it hit 4 units here. Pretty nice. And... could probably kill all these tanks in a couple passes with this bomber. Let's see. Yeah, pretty nice. 6 kills on this Tam. 3 kills on this one. That's one OP Tam. Got double that. So, let's look at reclaim. Mephi, a bit more. 400 more. Mass reclaim, there's a transport for Torin. But energy reclaim is way more for Mephi. And I'm not sure why. He has gotten all this, but Torin has all this as well. Yeah, still see a lot of trees on the map, so I'm not entirely sure why he has so much power reclaim. And T2 land for Mephi. Kind of interesting to see T2 land from the Cybern player before the Seraphim player. Where is that T2 land upgrade for Torin? Well, he looks to be doing pretty okay with T1 land. Just needs to scout this position and not run his tanks into a PD. I guess he has enough RDs here to kill it pretty quick. And he has taken this position. I think he probably reclaimed those land factories. It's the quickest way to do it. Mephi, still in the water, hasn't really achieved much with his commander at all. Not in position to defend here. Hasn't been able to do any damage here. Lost this position as well, but managed to regain it. So definitely better comm usage from Torin at the so far compared to Mephi, but he is getting T2 in the water, so you just chilling, hanging out. And Torin also getting T2. Not really sure why you get T2. I guess for Torin, he is actually very exposed. He has no anti-airs with him, and he doesn't have air control. Let's see the air count now, actually, because Torin has been trying pretty hard to get back into air. Does have 3 air factories. Let's see, 11 interceptors. Here we got, yeah, pretty much double. But still, I see a kind of a lack of bombers. We only got 2 out now. And wow. Yeah, this T2 land, I don't think this has been good for Mephi so far. He's lost a lot of positions just to T1 land, just Torin having more T1 land. He's lost this, he's lost this. This is kind of pretty painful now to lose two factories. Mechs, Hydro, all of these mechs is dead. And Torin decided not to get T2. I think he... Well, I missed something here. I think Meffy dropped here and managed to take out PD, and he actually made a T2 support factory. Or maybe it was the Torin. No, yeah, I think Meffy's just still had this for all this time. And Torin tried to take it out but was unsuccessful. You can see the walls are damaged. But there's a T2 support factory here. That is pretty cool. One thing that would be nice to see is maybe a T2 NG could make a TML, but then saying that there is only one thing worth TMLing at the minute, the T2 mechs. Another one on the way, but no T2 land. It's pretty strange that I don't see any T2 land. Because as the game goes on, I mean, the T2 land will just... It's eventually gonna just wreck all this T1 land once he gets a few more rhinos out. This is a nice rhino drop here, but that looks like too many tanks, and there goes the PD very quickly to all those SAMs. These poor rhinos have been dropped into a really bad situation. But even if they die, they're gonna get a fuck ton of kills doing it. There's 13 kills on this rhino. This guy is missing. Oh no, what is that? Why is that rhino missing? Or maybe he's shooting something behind, but no, I think it was missing. It only had 2 kills. Torin is not afraid of an old PD. There you can see he's shooting PD there, he has a good angle. But no, he stopped shooting it. And poof. So now time to reclaim some factories, get a nice mass boost. Reclaim the PD, that's a nice mass boost as well. 200 mass there. A lot of mass all over this map. And oh, looks like another drop of rhinos. And there's no radar, so no one is doing anything in this fight, because they can't see each other. Meffy wants to close this choke. It's kind of closing the barn door. And the horses have bolted. This position is dead. There's already units here. And Torin is leaving. I don't understand why. And there's rhinos everywhere. Got a rhino here, it's gonna kill all of this. Got a couple of rhinos, looks like they got dropped here. We got the rhinos dropped here. They actually cleaned everything up. 10 kills, 6 kills. So much reclaim here as well. Got another drop, and Torin's drop just got bombed the fuck out. Anti-air doesn't finish. Gotta split those NGs. When you drop, you always gotta split. Okay, eco. See Meffy, significantly more reclaim. And that's gonna be a big factor. 3 T2 mexes for Torin. Meffy's base is only decorated with a single one. And there's a T2 support factory. That means we have a T2 HQ somewhere. Here it is. I wonder how long this was here. Well, I know one way to try and find out is to see how many Ilshis we have. We have 6. One over here. We got, so I think we've seen 5 Ilshis coming out of this factory already. So it's been there a little while. It does have a lot of assist. And that is, I would never do that. Just build it in your base. It's not very secure here. I'm still wondering why Torin decided he should just walk away after basically winning this position, then just walked away, leaving two factories here, one being a T2 spore factory. Quite bizarre. But there you go. And he needs to be careful. This, by putting your T2 HQ here, you make this a huge target. Because, I mean, losing your HQ really fucking sucks. And, oh, that's a dead mech. I wonder if that was upgrading. It could well have been. Nice manual reclaim from Torin. And this position is dead for Mephi again. Hasn't managed to reclaim. This position needs to drop some units. And that's T2 air over halfway done. More rhinos appear and they're shooting inties instead of tanks. Okay, there we go. Should probably just... Well, he's got a kite. But that's not happening. Still doing pretty good damage. You can see just how good rhinos are versus T1. Regularly will get 10 plus kills versus T1 units. Problem is when you go up against T2, but when you have 4 versus 1, you're gonna do pretty good as well. But now with 3 Ilshis supported by Zooies, don't think these rhinos are gonna survive the encounter. Now a much stronger force here. We got Ilshis, we have Flak, and they're moving into this position, but Mephi's never actually rebuilt it, so nothing to kill there. And Mephi's still here in the water. It seems like he never really... He had a goal here to cut off this position with his ACU, and he's obviously failed, considering this T1 and T2 army that's on the other side of him. Torin has a lot of kills on his ACU. 39 kills, 2 vets, and no upgrades. So I think he may have achieved more than Mephi's T2 commander could have achieved, even more if he had stayed here and taken this back. I think he would be in a great position if he had actually done that. Now we see Corsairs. And we have 34 interceptors for Mephi, still completely dominant there. That's so much flak here. He needs to spread this out better. All of his flaks are here. Need to see some flak out of this factory as well, or he will just get killed by Corsairs. And this gun commander, it's strange to go for gun now, it's quite late, and it's quite dangerous when your opponent has T2 air to try and use your commander offensively, because Corsairs can snipe flak, so you gotta be careful versus a cyber. And this drop is nice, but units arrive on the scene just in time. And this is, oh, it's dying to Corsairs. That's unfortunate. Only bad thing about Corsairs, they'll kill lots of reclaim, probably. They're probably gonna overkill what they hit. And yeah, we can see a lot of assist on this factory. Mephi's really going for this T2 air. And Mephi, he basically can't come out of the water. There's just so many units here that he has to be very careful. And we don't see any T3 switch from any player. Mephi's also not daring to upgrade any more mexes. Just got 2 T2 mexes, so this is quite strange. I think if we look at generated mass, I'm surprised Meph even has so much, because he has so little map control by the looks of it. I mean, he hasn't got this or any of this here. It's quite amazing he still has this, to be honest. I mean, just think if Torin had killed this when he had it gifted to him. If this is dead, I think Meffy is dead as well. So Torin can't feel good about that. Meanwhile, Torin done a great job. He's denied this, but he's also lost a lot of mexes here. He destroyed this, but never actually held it for long. I think he just had a couple of mexes and then he got wiped out of there again. And Torin hasn't made any flak in this position. Unless it got sniped, which is possible. Is that a... not sure what that is. Could be a flak. So, maybe he did get sniped. Wouldn't be the strangest thing in the world. Corsairs are really good at sniping flak. You can dodge though, if you just keep your flak moving, then you can dodge Corsairs pretty good. And the Corsairs won't get many passes at all. So much reclaim here. But Meffy is powerless to get it. He could just stand here and overcharge Ilshis as they pass. That would be pretty great. He should also get stealth, I think, because he just has no support. So having stealth would make him so much safer. If he just dips into the water, he's kind of okay. Now we have TMD going up. That is extremely late to be making TMD, but better late than never. And Torin walked up here and then decided to walk back again. What are you thinking, man? What is this ACU doing? I think he just likes to walk more than anything. Just likes to walk. These Corsairs are out of position. They're gonna... well, they're probably not gonna lose any. Actually, you may lose this one. Oh, the INT is right up his hole. And there he goes. 420 mass. 420 blazed in the ocean. So many Corsairs from Meffy. That's quite a lot. He should really use them. He doesn't seem to be using them that much. He killed some army over here. That was good, but this is the kind of thing, like, he should be looking and take advantage of the all the time that there is no shield here. Now there is a shield, so he basically can't snipe this. I mean, 13k, that means he needs to do 13 passes pretty much to kill the shield, to get the shield down. 13 passes with one Corsair. So you'd need 3 passes with these 5. And there's gonna be flak if he tries to do that. So not really possible. He could snipe the HQ. I think that would actually be really cool. There isn't flak here. And yeah, losing your HQ, as I said, really sucks. Because it's just going to stop production in every single support factory until you have a new HQ. So that's the real pain. It's not really the cost of remaking HQ, it's the lost time, the lost production time on all your support factories. And this is dangerous. This is a lot of tanks. The only pity is there's only 3 arty. If he had more arty, this would be really scary, because they just do so much damage. But as it is, 6 Ilshival is pretty good. There's a T2 PD. Don't know how helpful that will be. I think more T1 PD is a better option. But the walls are really the MVPs here. Just all the tanks getting squeezed through a tiny gap. This PD is dead now. More PDs. This one is going to get finished. And the T2 PD is finished. A Rhino is out. So, what do you target in this position? I mean, see, he's on the wrong side, the PGen is over here, that's really what you would love to hit, but As of now, killing these pigeons, not a big deal. I think this is ultimately a failure. He leaves a lot of reclaim. Let's see if Meffy has the power to use that. He does. And he loses build power. And he forces 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 PDs. That's like 1200 mass. So he spent quite a lot of mass on PDs to stop that. So maybe he could actually reclaim a couple of PDs afterwards, but maybe also he shouldn't, considering he has a single rhino on the side of the map. So maybe just close up the wall, and also wall here as well, and then he'd be pretty much okay. It's kind of shocking, the map control split is just so bizarre. I mean, up here we have Meffy drops this position very well. That's pretty nice, and he has zero units to defend this. He has these mexes. He has no units anywhere near his base. All of his units are from like this proxy here, this proxy up here, this proxy here, and his commander. And there goes the HQ. He actually sniped the HQ and I fucking missed it. Well, sorry about that. But there you go, he snipes the HQ. That's pretty nice. Now, where is the new HQ? Is he upgrading a new HQ anywhere? Here, another proxy HQ. So this is Torin not learning his lesson, in my opinion. Don't think this is a good place to put a HQ. I guess he does have a lot of anti-air already built here, and his ACU is close, so I think maybe it's a better position than here, but I still think just put in your base, you know. So this gets cleaned out again, and Torin should just like throw down a factory or something, get some NGs over there. He should definitely kill this once and for all. It's really, well, it's just bizarre that it's still alive. I mean, great job for Meffy to actually make enough units out of this position to defend it, but also Torin, why did you let it live? So now Torin trying to get this again. This game, if you're playing this game, it would be just so strange, because it's not at all how a normal game looks. So the real problem is knowing exactly what the position is, whether you're ahead, in what ways are you behind, what you should actually do. So where should you focus? So we saw he tried to focus. Oh, T3 land. Oh, I love this move. T3 land is great. He kills the HQ. That gives him all the time he needs to go to Tech 3, because all the LG production just stops for a couple, 2-3 minutes, 4 minutes maybe. And that's all he needs to put his mass into T3, make that tech switch, and now he already had the T2 air, so he's just gonna drop those bricks. That's a great move by Meffy. But yeah, you see, you don't really know, or well, you should know, but it's harder to know exactly what the position is and what your advantages are, what you need to actually do, what positions you should be attacking, because it's just split so strangely. But Meffy, who was looking in a bad way, he has T3 land now, and that is a huge advantage when he has the ability to drop them wherever he wants. So he's gonna actually drop just here. I think he spotted the air coming for him. I don't think that's where he was intending to drop, but oh no, the poor Corsairs. Whoa, so many kills on these Corsairs. 24, 25 kills. And they're just gonna suicide. Oh, full vet Corsair. Oh my god. I don't think I've ever seen a full vet Corsair. Well, I don't remember seeing one. I probably have. But, they're actually getting even more kills by just following the Inties. But there they go. Oh, that's sad to see them die. And oh, n this HQ. This. Yeah. Torin didn't learn his lesson the first time, and I think he's about to lose his HQ to these two bricks. I don't see any way this HQ survives. I mean, there's only three Ushis now. Oh, T2 Radar is dead now. It's a great position for T2 Radar. Unlike the position for his HQ, this is game winning. I think these two bricks, if they move in here and kill this HQ, does Meffy know it's a HQ? He does, he has to go for this. And he should also get some radar over there so he can actually use the range of these bricks. Come on, don't waste any time. Because if he gets the HQ up and built, then yeah, no, that's not gonna happen. He doesn't have the mass to actually make it in any reasonable time, so I think no matter what, that's going down. He should just stop making it. He should actually, yeah, that's exactly what I was about to say. It was Control K and reclaim it. So good job there. Also reclaim. Oh, he should let that Ilshi finish. Well, I guess he can reclaim the Ilshi as well now. So yeah, he's just gonna just call it a day in this position, and that is really painful. Did he remake the HQ already? Before he control K'd? No. Oh no. That is sad. Meanwhile, over here, God, I've missed so much in this game. This game has been pretty mental. Is that HQ still not reclaimed? Oh, Meffy. That's pretty bad to not reclaim a T2 HQ, but yeah, now we see Torin once again returns to this position and leaves. He sees all these units coming for him, but really these are just T2 units. He can easily kill all of this. Just a few rhinos. Five rhinos, yeah, they're all gonna die pretty quick and just give him some vet. But this is dead again. This is dead. Meffy still has this all game. And Meffy has regained this. And he's gotten this. So this ACU eventually actually managed to win here, but it was more so I think the air and the Corsairs going in there to snipe. That did it. Torrent getting some vet. He has lost some HP to this battle, but if he gets another vet, he's gonna have quite a bit of HP. I don't think Meffy should be sending these rhinos towards the ACU unless he's planning to finish him off, because he's actually gonna give him more HP than he takes off him. Should see. So close to a vet there. Should see him jump. I don't know how much he'll get, 4 or 5K. So good attack in the. Oh, look at these T2 Pigeons. What are they doing here? I didn't even notice them, because I mean, why would you ever build T2 Pigeons here? But Meffy did instead of building them in his base. Like, I'm not sure why, but yeah, I think this replay is a bit of a lesson in why you don't build important shit in proxy bases. It just dies. Every time you build something important in a proxy base, like a HQ or a T2 PGen, you're just making that a focal point for your enemy to attack. So I think if you do it, maybe you do it and you have to be aware that the opponent is should attack there and probably will. So maybe you can like lure your opponent into attacking something that looks vulnerable, but more likely your opponent just builds up enough and kills it and you're in a ship position. So let's see Mephi's power right now. He actually has enough power because I guess he lost all those mexes and these mexes. These bricks don't want to walk into a gun comp. But the gun comp is not overcharging. He doesn't have OC. And I don't see him building it anywhere. And even if he was building it, he is stalling hard. Oh my god, Mephi can just... Okay. Oh, that took so much HP from him. He lost about 6k to that brick. For no reason. He was actually making... the energy storage, that's why he was stalling so much, in fact. Energy storage is quite expensive. 250 mass. Drains a lot, so it is a pain when you have to rush them because you probably stall mass and it doesn't build as fast as you would like. But that's really painful. It really hurts this ACU. Every HP you lose is pretty painful. I think a gun comm is not enough right now. I think he needs some nano comm. But really, what's winning this game is T3 land. Mephi lost this. Oh, he's actually gonna rebuild the PGen. And I mean, Torrent doesn't actually know that this is being rebuilt. But if he did, I mean, the bricks would not kill the hover arty's fast enough to save this BGen. He could easily have killed it there if he knew that was being rebuilt. And where's this ACU off to? He's just dropping him in the base. And we do have T3 land, and finally we have a HQ in the base. Mephi, meanwhile, yeah, these positions just keep getting killed and one player drops them, and then units arrive and kill the drops, and then units get dropped and kill the other units, and eventually just no one has the positions for most of the game. And again, we see NGs move in, but there's units on hand. And this brick is just silently sitting, regenning some HP. And there's a dead naval factory as well. This is something Torrent does, and it's pretty good. Yeah, you see the icon for frigate is the intel icon. And people ask, I mean, why? I remember, I think Athelas wanted to change the icon for it, or because, you know, it's not really used for intel. Well, in this game, and this map, it is used basically for intel. Look at this radar coverage from one frigate. I mean, it also has kills. Its anti-air can do something, but this is basically intel. I mean, if you put one here, you got all this. You can see all this from this position. So frigates are actually great for intel. You can just throw a couple out, and get intel all over the map. But yeah, you're gonna want to do that a bit later in the game because it's not a super cheap form of radar. Here's another brick drop. Are they gonna drop right onto these arties? This artie can't actually even shoot at this guy because he's inside the minimum range. But this is all dead. No engineers dropped though, so... Oh, there goes the T1 transport, dies to the arties. Doesn't really want to lose this T2 transport, that's not a cheap unit. And it's actually almost dead now. Oh, this arty is so annoying. This arty could probably be shooting the T2 pregen, and maybe even kill it. Let's see how much a T2 transport costs. 300 mass, So it's pretty expensive. Nice T2 radar from Mephi. Should surround it though. He doesn't really have much power to work with. These mechs often get upgraded, but they are so vulnerable to amphibious units that if you see that, you really need to take advantage of it. It's often better to just surround stuff in your base. That's actually T3 mech started. Surround stuff in your base and maybe secure this position. Have a solid base here and upgrade these, just so you're not so vulnerable to those annoying amphibious units like Wagners. And did Torin just drop into the middle of six bricks? Oh, Torin. Shit. Scheiße. That is. It's a suicide drop. I think if you look at this map, you can see what the story is. Mephi has grabbed pretty much most of the map and denied the rest of it. Torin is stuck in his base. He's lost almost everything, so I think Mephi pretty much was in a great lead. I don't think you could really contest it from this position. Got 11, 12 bricks, 2 in this transport. So that's a lot of bricks, and we only have 5 autumns, so yeah, pretty much one for Mephi already. I'm not sure what this drop was about. I'm pretty sure he dropped here. Don't think he just walked into the middle of those bricks. But yeah, really nice game and very APM heavy game. You saw a lot of drops, a lot of positions taken, lost, and retaken. And I think ultimately it was the HQ snipe which won the game when Mephi sniped the HQ with Corsairs, which I regrettably missed. But we saw the consequences of it. He killed the HQ. His commander actually became involved. He got some PDs down. Got reclaim in this position, sniped the HQ, and then secured this position somewhat. Although he did actually suffer another attack here, and had to retake it once again, but he secured it somewhat. And using the time gained by sniping this HQ, stopping all the Ilshi production here and here, he got T3 land, dropped bricks here. And then this HQ, once again, Torin just. Proxy HQs are. I don't know, I think they're just a bad idea in. I don't know, 95% of cases. Please tell me where they're good, but generally I think they just create a target. A very big target. And yeah, these two bricks killed Torin's HQ once again. And from there, he has to go from T1 land factory to T3 land factory, and there's already bricks on the field getting dropped everywhere. Yeah, you just aren't gonna win that game. So, really well played by Mephi and Torin. Just a great game overall. So, thanks for sending it in, Mephi. I didn't say who sent it in originally because it often gives away who actually won the game. But yeah, thanks for sending it in, Mephi, and send me your guys' replays if you see any good ones. And yeah, GG.